My personal feeling is that, and not only personal, it has a lot of references in the text, that any of your kalpa should have minimum number of medicines in it. Ideally, single dravya should be the best remedy for treatment. You can find it everywhere, especially in Charakvimansana Adhyaya. First, rasadosha prabhavatattvam vyavasthit sort of thing, how to choose a dravya in a disease. Rasavimana Adhyaya. But still, it needs a lot of expertise, so we have to use a lot of kalpa in our practice. But in my practice, I try to keep the number of medicine as less as possible, and mainly my practice is herbal. I use very less rasakalpa as such. In few of them, Vasanta Kalpas and Sutshekhar are on the top. Many people are surprised to see that I don't have any bottle of Aarogyavardhini or Chandraprabha, even not bottle in my clinic. I don't use those kalpas at all. I have a different thought process for that, but it's not our topic today. So in the beginning, what is important of dravya in our treatment schedule? These first two things we have already done in previous lectures, Vishak Dravya Anupastha Rogi Pada Chatushtayam, and we all know also. Bahukalpam, Bahugunam, Sampannam, Yogyam, Aushadam, a lot of wonderful discussion has been already done on this. But there are three types of dravyas, Tat Punas Trividam Proktam, Jangama, Udbhida, Parthivam. Jangama is animal origin, Udbhida is plant origin, and Parthiva is mineral origin. So there are three types of dravya, and all can be used in medicine. We know that Nasti Mulam Anaushadam. अमंत्रम अक्षरम नास्ति नास्ति मूलम अनौषधम अयोग्य पुरुषो नास्ति योजकस्तत्र दुर्लभा. सो यू कैन प्रैक्टिकली यूज एनीथिंग बिलो द सन एज मेडिसिन. ओनली थिंग इज दैट यू नीड टू बी अ गुड योजक. चरक हैज ऑल्सो एम्फसाइज योगादपि विषम तीक्ष्णम भेषजम उत्तमम भवेत. वी नो मीन्स विष कैन ऑल्सो बी यूज एज अ वंडरफुल मेडिसिन इन प्रॉपर वे. सो इन औषधि कल्प अगेन देर आर different types of kalpanas. Basically, Panchavikshaya kalpana are the most basic. So they are mainly from Jangama and Udbhida dravyas, mainly Jangama and mainly Udbhida plant origin and to some extent Jangama. And there are Parthiva dominant dravya kalpanas like Parada. There are again two types, Parada Yukta and Parada Virahita. So in some medicines, Parada is not there. For example, Tapradilo. And Parada Yukta, we know a lot of things, a lot of medicines are there. So these, what are the qualities of good Kalpana? This is my thought process because I am a very lazy person, you can say, बहुत आलसी हूँ मैं, तो मुझे बहुत जितना आसान मिले, जितना इजी मिले, उतना मुझे अच्छा लगता है. इसलिए माधव निदान मुझे अच्छा लगता है. उन्होंने बोला, भिषजाम अल्प मेधसाम, जिनकी बुद्धि कम है, जो आलसी लोग हैं, उनके लिए मैंने सभी जगह से जमा करके आपके लिए ये ग्रंथ बनाए, तो आपको श्रम ना पड़े सभी ग्रंथ देखने की. तो मेरे लिए, फॉर मी, इट शुड कंटेन सिंपल मेडिसिन्स, देन ऑल दोस कंटेंट शुड बी इजीली अवेलेबल, लेस नंबर ऑफ इंग्रेडिएंट शुड बी देयर. द थॉट प्रोसेस आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन. देन सिंपल प्रिपरेशन मेथड्स लाइक सिंदूर, से फॉर एग्जाम्पल सिंदूर कल्प, वेरी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड टू प्रिपेयर. देन इट शुड बी वेरी मच इजीली पैलेटेबल. फॉर एग्जाम्पल पंचगव्य घृत इज वेरी नाइस मेडिसिन, बट इट्स रियली वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर अ पेशेंट टू एनगल्फ इट. और देर आर मेनी सच, गुग्गुल तिक्तम घृतम, वंडरफुल मेडिसिन, महातिक्तम घृतम, बट पैलेटेबिलिटी इज अ लिटिल बिट इशू. अगेन इट शुड बी कॉस्ट इफेक्टिव, इट शुड नॉट बी वेरी कॉस्टली. देन ब्रॉड स्पेक्ट्रम, इट शुड वर्क ऑन मेनी डिसीजेस, और इट शुड बी संपन्नम सॉर्ट ऑफ थिंग. And it should not have or very minimal adverse effect, even if they are there, and highly efficacious. So it is said that if you want to buy a cow, एक गाय अगर आपको खरीदनी है तो कैसी होनी चाहिए? वो कपिल वर्ण की होनी चाहिए, सस्ते में मिलनी चाहिए, उसने चारा कम खाना चाहिए, घास कम खाना चाहिए, दूध ज्यादा देना चाहिए, दूध निकलते वक्त उसने आपको लात नहीं मारनी चाहिए, शांत स्वभाव की. तो सभी गुण उस गाय में होने चाहिए. इसी तरह से ये सभी तरह के गुण हमारे मेडिसिन में होना चाहिए एज मच एक्सटेंट एज पॉसिबल. सो दिस इज माई पर्सनल थॉट प्रोसेस, बिकॉज मे बी आई बिलोंग टू पुणे सिटी एंड इन दैट सदाशिव पेट. सो most of us know the speciality of Pune and especially Sadashivpet. So these all, I think, they reflect my expectation from my medicine. So is it possible to get all these qualities in one kalpa? So the answer is Vasanta Kalpa for me. We'll come to that afterwards. Now these Vasanta Kalpanas are chiefly Parthiva but Parada Virahit. There is no Parada in Vasanta Kalpa as a principal ingredient. Yes, of course, there is a Hingul or Darada in Suvarnamalini Vasanta which contains Parada, but it's indirect. Like in Sesut Shekhar, Shuddham Sutam Rutam Swarnam sort of thing. So Parada and Gandhak, they are not directly are mentioned in that. In Lagumalini Vasanta, Madhumalini Vasanta, there is no Parada. So they are my drug of choice and they fulfill all the criteria of good Kalpa. Now just take another look on these criteria and see, just see whether all the criteria are met by Vasanta Kalpas. Only cost effective, there can be some issue with Suvarnamalini Vasanta, but we'll deal with that also afterwards. Otherwise, all other things are very much fitting in my expectations. So no doubt that Vasanta Kalpana are my drug of choice. Now why this name Vasanta? They could have given any name. Vasanta Rutu or spring, what we observe in the society or in the Pind or Brahmanda is that there is a new leaves. They are following mega shedding off in Shishir. So there is a new generation. So it's a symbol of liveliness and new genesis. And not only new genesis, but especially after some great loss. In Shishira Rutu, that plant is losing all its leaves. And in Vasanta, new leaves are provided to that plant. So that's the beauty of Vasanta Rutu. So when the plant is losing its leaves, is similar to a person leaving his vigor or losing his vigor due to Vyadhi. We call it as a Vyadhikshina type of person. So Vasanta Kalpana are most ideal for Vyadhikshina type of people. Now there is one another thing. Vyadhikshina is a Apatarpan Avastha. There are two types of diseases. Upakramya, we know this. Upakramya Sehiditva Dvidhaya Upakrama Matha. Ekasantarpanastatra Dvitiyashtapatarpana. So there are Santarpanottavyadhi and Apatarpanottavyadhi. If Santarpanottavyadhis are there, we need Apatarpan. And if Apatarpanottavyadhis are there, we need Santarpan. But there are some conditions where we need both. We need Apatarpan as well as Santarpan. So the medicine which we need is again has to be both the qualities, like a all-rounder in cricket. He knows batting as well as bowling sort of thing. So this is what is written there. Many times we observe Apatarpan Avastha in Santarpanottavyadhi. Is it contradicting? Is it sounding something foolish? Apatarpan Avastha in Santarpanottavyadhi? Yes, in text also such type of vyadhis are mentioned. The most common example is Pramya. Kaleno Upekshita Sarve Yadyanti Madhumehatam. And that time, Apatarpan is at its peak. And Meheshu Santarpanam Eva Karyam is the Chikitsa Sutra for Pramya. So there are many such avasthas where Apatarpan Avastha is the effect of Santarpanottha disease. Now, if you want to give Santarpan, then what is the rule or Santarpan or Apatarpan? Na Bruhaye Langaniyan Bruhyastu Mudu Langai. This is from Ashtang Rudai Sutrasthan, 14th chapter. You should not give Bruhan to those who need Apatarpan. But those who need some Bruhan, you must give some Apatarpan in the beginning and then only you can give Bruhan. This is the guideline. Now Vasanta Kalpa fulfill this criteria very, very nicely. They are doing all the things as I mentioned. They do no bowling, batting, wicket keeping, fielding, all the things. Cleanse, nourish, nurture and rejuvenate. All the four qualities are there in any Vasanta Kalpa. So it's an all-rounder type of medicine. Adhikar of this Lagumalini Vasanta or Suvarnamali, we have many previous speakers have already talked wonderfully regarding Adhikar. So Jirna Jvara and Rajayashma, Jvara or Jirna Jvara. So what is Jirna Jvara? Three saptahe vyati deto Jvara Jirna Anuvartare. 3 weeks of fever. Again, the condition leading somewhere to Vyadhikshina Avastha. What is the Chikitsa Sutra for Jirna Jvara? Yes, Jirna Jvara to Sarveshu, Sarpishap Panam Prashasyate. So, Snehan, Deepan, Bruhan, शमन तर्पण दिस इज अ ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ जीर्ण ज्वर एंड व्हाट इज राजयक्ष्मा फॉरगेट दैट बिग संप्राप्ति व्हाट आर द थ्री प्रिंसिपल इवेंट्स दैट आर ऑकरिंग इन अ राजयक्ष्मा पेशेंट स्रोतसामसन निरोधाच फर्स्ट रक्तादिनांच संशयात सेकंड एंड धातुष्मणांच अपचयात थर्ड सो इफ दीज थ्री इवेंट्स आर ऑकरिंग इन एनी डिसीज यू कैन नेम इट एज राजयक्ष्मा एंड यू कैन यूज वसंतकल्प वेरी नाइसली वी नो दैट विकारनामा कुशलो एवरीबडी नोज सो इट मे नॉट बी ऑलवेज अ राजयक्ष्मा पेशेंट बट एनी सच कंडीशन यू नीड टू नो द अवस्था एंड नॉट द नेम ऑफ दैट कंडीशन And again, what one more important thing is occurring as a result of all the three events, it is given in Ashtang Rudra Nidhanasthan, Rasopesyan Raktaya Mausaya Kutayavat. अभी ये राजयक्ष्मा पेशेंट का जो रस धातु है वो रक्त तक जाने को भी पॉसिबल नहीं उसको क्यों क्यों क्योंकि स्रोतोरोध भी है तो आगे जाएगा कैसे फिर धातु क्षय भी है और इन दोनों चीजों की वजह से रक्तादि का क्षय है तो रसोपेस्यन रक्ताय This rasa dhatu is not able to get converted even in rakta dhatu. Then when it will get converted into mausa and medha and asti? So upastabdasya shakruta kevalam vartate kshayi. So shakrut is the only balam of that patient. So these things we have to keep in mind while using vasantakalpa. This is a laghumalini vasant. We all know this shlok. I am not going in much details of that. Everything is written in there and we all know as well what are the ingredients kharpara nowadays we use jasad basma then maricha navanita and nimbuka now how many days to triturate is not written so it's a sign convention as we learn in mathematics say mathematics that if you don't write any sign in front of a number say you say only 12 it is understood that it means plus 12 if you want to say minus 12 then you have to give a minus sign But if you want to say plus 12, then no need to give plus sign. It is understood. Similarly, there are some conventions in Ayurveda. If, for example, if your guru asks you to bring some milk or kshir lao, so you are not supposed to stand up there and ask which milk do you want: cow milk, buffalo milk, camel milk, or donkey milk, whatever. You have to go immediately and bring cow milk. Then if a guru asks to bring you tailam, again same thing. Don't ask which taila, tila taila, uma taila, kusumba taila, iranda taila. Immediately go and bring tila taila because tilodhavam tailam. The taila word itself comes from tila. So when only taila is told, you have to bring tila taila. If some utensil is asked, again don't ask which one, earthen pot or golden, silver, copper. No, go and bring earthen pot. So these are conventions. Similarly, in Aushadhikaran, if it is not mentioned how many days to triturate, then generally it is accepted that 42 days of trituration should be given, done, which means one mandal, which is equal to 6 weeks. So 6 weeks you have to triturate in nimbu, initially navanita and then nimbu. So there are only two medicines and two bhavana dravyas. Again, there is one interesting thing about this nimbu nirena. This, please forgive me for the spell or nimbu nirena. This anuspar is lacking over there. In Bruhatrayi, if you see in Amlaskanda, or nowhere in Bruhatrayi, nimbu or lemon has been mentioned. For example, in Ashtangrude, there is amla varga, amlo dhatri phalamlika matulunga amla vetasam dadivam rajatam takram chukram palevatam dadi amram amratakam bhavyam kapitam karamardakam वृक्षाम्लकोललकुच कोशाम्लातक धन्वन मस्तुधान्याम्ल मध्यानि जंबीरं तिलकंटकम् इन ऑल दिस नोवेयर नींबू इज नॉट एट ऑल मेंशन्ड समबडीज माइक इज आई थिंक रिमेनिंग ऑन काइंडली टर्न ऑफ योर माइक सो इट वाज नॉट देयर ड्यूरिंग द बृहत्त्रय टाइम्स थैंक यू फॉर टर्निंग ऑफ So Nimbu has entered India in the Laghutrayi or Rasa Shastra times, and we have used it in our medicine. Now these are the qualities. Again, we know. Just have a small recap: Kashaya Tikta, Shita Virya, and good for Kapha Pitta, Jasad Bhasma, mainly on Meha, Pandu, and Shwasa. All these three are Santarpanottha diseases, but again, they need Santarpan as their treatment. additionally jasada bhasma is chakshusham as well. So this is about jasada bhasma. Maricha, again it is katurasa, ushna virya, ati ushna, we can say. Then tikshna ruksha and dipan type of quality, kapha vatagna and pitta prakopa. It works for mainly for shvasa shula and krumi. You have to keep all these things in mind, because afterwards for case presentation all these things are going to be needed. One more peculiar quality of maricha that we know is it is pramathi. It's in Sharangdhar Samhita. What is the meaning of pramathi? Nijavirena yadravyam srotobhyo dosha sanchayam nirasyati pramathisya tadyatha maricham vacha. So nijavirena, any dravya or any substance, because of its own potency, it goes into the srotasas and nirasyati, just snatches out all the collection which is there inside the srotas and clarifies the srotas. It is called as pramathi, and maricha is the best example of pramathi followed by vacha. So maricha is used in this kalpa, so we can know that it is very good srotas shodhan type of medicine. Previously jasad bhasma is overall cleansing type of and nourishing. It is also believed that it is good for dhatu sneha parampara, rasa draptam tato mausam mausad madhas tato stishva. So jasad bhasma is very good for dhatu sneha parampara, preparing next or further and further dhatus better. For that channels should be open. This work is done by maricha. Always keep in mind that rajayakshma srotasam sannirodhaccha raktadinancha sanshaya dhatushmanancha apacha. So for srotasam sannirodhaccha maricha is there. Navanita, again we know this is from Ashtang Rudra Sutra Sthan, 5th chapter, Navanitam Navam Rusham and all those things. It is Madhura Rasa Shita Virya Vrushya Balya. It is again Deepan Agnikrut, that means Deepan. Again it is Balya, means providing nourishment. Varna is again dependent on Pitta, so we can call it as a Pitta Shama, definitely Vata Shama. It is a Kshaya, Arsha, Ardit and Kasa, is the spectrum. Again it is nutrition, so Maricha will cleanse the channel and nutrition of Navaneet or butter will reach the end organ, is the concept behind that. And Nimbukam, it is Amlam, Vataganam, Deepanam, Pachanam, Laghu. So it is Amlaras, Vatashamak, Laghu, Deepan and Pachan. So it's a wonderful combination of all the paraspar virodhi things and coming in a very nice proportion and giving us excellent results in our practice. So this is just a tabular presentation, just as a recap. Okay, so what is the sum total effect? Now srota shodhan is there, cleansing, which is mainly maricha but supported by jasada and nimbuka. Amla ras, tamlogni dipti krus nikdo rudya pachana rochana ushna virya himasparsha prinana kledano lagu. Okay, so amla rasa is doing all those functions. Karoti kapha pittasra mudhavatanulomanam. So mudhavatanuloman is also a function of amla rasa. So nimbu is doing it very nicely. Then prinan, amla is also rudya. So nimbu ka jasad and navanita. Now here maricha is gone and navanita has come. So srota shodhan, this tried. Prinan, this tried. Then asravan or kledan, navanita and nimbuka. Navanita is again, we have already seen, it's mrutsna, and nimbuka also, it causes kledan of the organ because being of amla rasa. And snehan or oleation, again navanita dominant but amla rasa also helps. So all these team members are working in a wonderful harmony. Batsman is doing his job, bowler is doing his job, wicketkeeper is doing his job and fielders are doing their job very nicely. So the team has to win the match in any case. So this is the sum total effect. What is the pictorial presentation? You can see all the four different types of works this Laghumalini Vasanta is doing, and this is the Laghumalini Vasanta, you can say, the central part. All four qualities in it. Again, this Srotamukha Vishodhan is also important for Koshthagati of dosha. Doshayanti tathatebhya srotomukha vishodhana. In Laghumalini Vasanta, Maricha is doing this job. Then Vruddhya, Vruddhi of dosha. Navanita is doing this job. Abhishandana, Navanita and Nimbuka together are doing this job. So out of five, three things which are next important for bringing all those doshas to the Koshtha are there in Laghumarini Vasanta. So it can work to bring all the doshas from Shakha to Koshtha very nicely. Vagbhat says that Trayas Tiryagata Dosha Shamaya Kleshe Antyaturam Shiran. Tiryagat jo dosh ho gaye wo atur ko bahut zyada takleef dete. Shamaye tan prayogena sukham va koshtha mane. Aap aaye to unka udhari shaman kar do ya fir usko koshtha mein leke aao. So whatever is the need, Laghumalini Vasanta is a drug of choice. Now let's come to official Phalashruti. Why official? Because it's mentioned by text, but we can use it in many other ways as per our thought process. Kuriya duhyam swayam dhiya. All the Charak, Sushrut, Vagbhat, all the people were very open and they wanted their disciples to use their own brain and do newer things in their lives. Shastram Jyoti Prakash Artham Darshanam Buddhir Atmana. Shastra is like a torch that will only show, spread light. It will only enlighten. But it's your eyes what they want to see in that eyes, so in that light. So that is very important. So this is official Phalashruti, and accordingly how we use this kalpa in today's era we'll discuss afterwards. So I think most of us know all these verses. Jirna jware dhatu gate iti sare rakkan vite rakta bhave peche doshe valladvayam duddhayutancha patyam. Then pradaram nashayatyashu tatha durnam shonitam vishamam netra rogancha. Or this is Vishancha Netra Roganji, it's a part way over there. Gajendram Iva Kesari, Vasanto Malini Purvam, Shir Sarva Roga Harashisho, Sarva Jvara Harashrashto Garbha Poshanam. So Jvara, Jirna Jvara, Dhatugat Avastha, Rakta. Okay. So this is the official Phalashruti of, sorry for the technical disturbance. This is the official Phalashruti, Jirna Jvara, Dhatugateti Sare. So Jvara, Jirna Jvara, Dhatugateti. Gatavastha, then Pitta Dosh, Ghora Pitta Dosh, Rakta Dosh, then Pradara, Durnama means Arsha, again Vishamam Netra Rogam, Visha and Vishamam Netra Rogam, Garbha Poshanam Uttamaha, all these are the Phalashruti diseases mentioned for Laghumalini Vasanta. So what is the spectrum of this Kalpa? Annava Srotas, yes, Dipan Pachan. Rasava Srotas, again Dipan Pachan things are for good digestion and good Rasa Dhatu is getting prepared. So obviously Rasava Srotas along with its Upadhatu, Stanya, especially Stanya Shodhan and Artava also, Sin Pradaram Nashayatyashu. So and again Garbha Poshan as well. So it is good for Rasava Srotas. Then Raktava Srotas, Durnam Shonitam or Ghoranyathe Pitta Bhavecha Doshe. So Raktava Srotas. Pranava Srotas, there is Maricha which is good for Kasa Shvasa, Navanita which is again good for Kasa Shvasa, so Pranava Srotas. Jirana Dhatugat Avastha, Dhatugat Jvar, Dhatugat Atisar, all those are drug means diseases of choice for this drug. And Bahudosha patients who need Santarpana, even though they are Bahudosha or Santarpanatha, still they need Santarpana because as an effect of disease, apatarpana has taken place. Prameha is the classical textual example and cancer is the classical example of today's era. So depending upon all this thought process of Phalashruti and all its contents, in modern days or in today's era, how to use or in which condition this kalpa can be used very aptly. So these are the common diseases in which I am using Laghumalini Vasanta. Now these diseases are not mentioned in this Phalashruti. But still, all these our Granthakaras are very much open and they want us to use our own brains, not only spoon feeding type of thing from them. Charak says, Kuriya Duhyam Swayam Dhiya. You use your own intellect and think accordingly and do newer things. Shastram Jyoti Prakash Artham Darshanam Buddhir Atmana. Shastra is like a torch. It will just show you light in the darkness. Now what you want to see will depend on your eyes, that is your Buddhi. So your Buddhi is also equally important. So accordingly, whatever guidance is there in your texts, you have to implement them in today's practice. Again, there are two schools of thought. few people say that no, no, you should not go through this modern investigation, no modern medicine at all, nothing doing, only Ayurveda type of examination and treatment accordingly. And there is another school of thought who say, no, no, modern diagnosis, Ayurveda treatment. The most classical example is, if cancer is the diagnosis, Hirakosma is there. So this type of thought process can also be there. Both are correct. I'm not saying anything is wrong, but that's their way of thinking. My way of thinking is Naikantavad. I follow Jainism, Naikantavad. All you have to take good from everyone. So you take help of modern medicine for Pratyaksha Jnan. You take help of Ayurveda for this Aptavachan. And accordingly, you do your own thing, which is mentioned by Sushruta. Pratyakshatoi yadrushtam, shastradrushtam chayadvavet, samasatastadubayo bhuyo jnana vivardhana. You see, whatever is in Pratyaksha, which is modern medicine, is telling you many Pratyaksha things, which are visible directly. Shastradrushtam chayadvavet, what Shastra is thinking about it. And samasatastadubayo, use those both, bhuyo jnana vivardhanam, and increase your knowledge and utilize it for the society. So I am not using that, every IBS patient I am not going to use Laghu Malini Vasan. We will go through that case. I will giving some examples now, so you will get a little bit idea. And accordingly, if you agree with it, yes, you can definitely incorporate. If you don't agree, then always you can leave the thought process. But just you should know that there are people who think in this way also. Is it right or no, wrong is not our cup of tea. Okay. Because everyone is getting good results. All these thought processes are getting good results in their setups. So IBS, anemia, diabetes, psoriasis, leukemia, cancer, all these diseases in which these Vasanta Kalpas or especially Laghu Malini Vasanta can be very nicely used. So this is one IBS case which came to me in May 2019. Now again, only IBS and Laghu Malini Vasanta, not the case. You need to know all the case properly, and if all the things they fit for Laghu Malini Vasanta, then only you have to use Laghu Malini Vasanta in that, not as a thumb rule. So for that, aturasya antaratmanam yona vishati yogivat jnana buddhi pradipena nasarogash chikitsati. So you have to enter inside the patient with your jnana buddhi pradip and know whatever is going on inside him, and then treat. Rogamado parikshetha tato nantaram aushadam. Don't hurry for the medicine. So tomorrow any IBS patient will come, we had learned in Kalpabhyas for IBS Laghu Malini Vasanta is good. No, there should be proper reasoning behind that. Okay. So in this case, 28-year-old male IT professional, he had complaints since 1 year, dull pain in umbilical and epigastric region, especially after food intake. Then sticky and semi-solid stools after food intake immediately. As soon as he washes his hand, he has to rush to the toilet. Like Anu Asan Basti, it is told that Ardra Panina, after having food, when the hands are still wet after washing, immediately you have to give Anu Asan. Here, he had to rush to the toilet, Ardra Panina. That's the only difference. Very severe anorexia, which was reflected in his weight loss, almost 7 kg weight loss in 7 months. It was the condition. And because of all this, impotence was also developing in him. Now, there were past history of recurrent indigestion since childhood. Means his digestion was never very good since childhood, but now it had worsened. Jaundice also, 8 years ago, it was there. Now, if you want to summarize all these things, and whether Laghu Malini Vasanta fits in this. Dal pain, amla rasa, shulagna. Then maricha, ushna ruksha shulagna, amapacha. Then sticky and semi-solid stools, again maricha, to dry up that excessive cough. Then anorexia, all the medicines in Laghu Malini Vasanta are dipan and pachana sort of. Weight loss, once the anorexia is removed, these rotasas get cleansed, then nourishment will automatically reach to the end organs. So, there is a book called Aushadhi Sangraha by Dr. Vaman Ganesh Desai, very old book. He was a medical doctor, but he has coined a word called as Katu Poushti. Those are Katu Dikta Rasatma, but still they are nutritive. Like Guduchi, it is Katu Dikta, but it is Rasayana sort of thing. or patola, katu dikta, but again it is rasayan. So this type of medicine we need. So this all, is it like Rajayakshma? Srotasam san nirodhaccha, raktadinancha sankshaya, dhatushmanan chapachaya, Rajayakshma pravatani. So Lagumalini Vasanta is a best drug for this type of condition. Again, history of jaundice and indigestion since childhood. Jaundice again, Shonitaj rog. So Lagumalini Vasanta again. Now he was investigated, colonoscopy was done, inflamed mucosa was there. He took that treatment for 3 months, but not much. Etiology, stress was, a lot of stress was there regarding his marriage, there were some issues. And again, job related also, there were some severe stress. So as a sum total of all these things, all these symptoms were emerging. Again, mother had colitis in her family history. So treatment plan was Lagumalini Vasanta, Lagu Sutshekhar, Mausi, Dhamasa, with few other medicines. Of course, these are not the only medicine used, but these are the majority medicine. Again, not this medicine used for whole period. As per the avastha changes, some medicine is changed here and there. But as a sum total effect, after 7 months of treatment, he got complete symptomatic relief. Good nutrition, good appetite, and good digestion, no abdominal pain, normal bowel movement. Weight gain was there 5 kg in 7 months. Now he came to 56 kg. And important is his impotence completely relieved. And he married also in February, I think, just before starting the lockdown. He got married. And after his marriage, immediately after 1 or 2 months, lockdown was there. And he specially invited me for that marriage. So I had been there, and it was a good thing to see that our patient is now doing very well in his life. So this is first case. This is a one very peculiar case of cachexia, which came to me in April 2015. 24-year-old female, she was already done LLB and now doing some further education. Had complaints of chronic indigestion since 4 to 5 years. Semi-solid motions on and off, sometimes normal, sometimes abnormal. Kwachit mur baddham mur dravam sort of. No abdominal pain, no flatulence was there. Severe anorexia, frequent stomatitis was there. Again, ghoranyathe pitta bhavecha doshe, stomatitis. Insomnia was there, very less, 2 or 3 hours of only sleep, and that too, not very sound. No any specific menstruation was luckily good. It's a really perplexing that there was no problem with menstruation. And severe cachexia, you can see weight was not even 30 kg when she came to me. 24-year lady, less than 30 kg of weight. Now she had some important past history. She was a LSCS born baby, and that time birth weight was good, 5 to 6 pounds something. Then she had some study related phobia 5 years ago, and suffered with bhaya jati sar because of that phobia for almost 1 year, means 5 years to 4 years. 1 year she was suffering from bhaya jati sar. And even before that, in 7th standard, because of some study related phobia, she took 1 year gap